Think you're a Minecraft expert? Well, not for long. Minecraft is a huge game, and I'm willing to bet there are a ton of features you've never heard of. So here it is, 30 more secret Minecraft things you probably didn't know. So sit back, relax, and let me know in the comments how many you knew. I'm sure it's not gonna be that much. Also, we're only 50,000 subscribers away from 750K, 3/4 away to 1 million. A really large percentage of people who watch these videos aren't actually subscribed, so if you do end up enjoying the video, then please consider subscribing. It'd be really awesome and help out the channel a ton. I really do appreciate it, but with that said, let's get straight into it, and I hope you enjoy the video. Number 1. You can use lapis to find diamonds in Minecraft. Lapis is one of the more useless ores, with pretty much its only purpose being enchanting, but not anymore. In the new Minecraft version, if you find lapis underground and dig 4 blocks north or in the negative Z direction, you will find diamonds the moment you turn downwards, making this ore now one of the best in the whole game. Also, if this doesn't work, chances are you ran into a chunk border, and I'll explain how to bypass that at the end of the video. Number 2. Crouching, or sneaking, while being a universal sign of peace, also has a really good and practical use. If you crouch, hostile mobs will only be able to detect you from 80% of their usual range. For example, creepers that can usually see you from 16 blocks away will only be able to see you from 12 blocks away if you crouch, making this very useful for caving and whenever you don't want to get spotted or die. Number 3. But why sneak when you can use mob heads? You probably know that if a charged creeper blows up a mob, that mob will drop its skull. But what you might not know is that if you wear that skull, mobs of that type will only be able to see you from half of their usual distance. So if you are a skeleton head, skeletons that can usually detect you from 16 blocks away will now only notice you from 8 blocks away. In my opinion, this is one of the coolest features in all of Minecraft and makes this item that I thought was completely useless actually really useful. Lover fella, you definitely want to test this one out. Number 4. One of the first things you learn about Minecraft is the golden rule, never to dig straight down. I mean, you might run into lava, caves, and even ravines. Or will you? After inspecting terrain generation, it's actually relatively safe to dig straight down. In fact, in any given world, you have a 64% chance of digging into nothing and just reaching bedrock, and only a 6% chance of digging into lava. Even then, with the use of a water bucket, you'll be completely fine. So the next time you're going mining, feel free to ignore this rule and don't worry about digging straight down. You'll be alright. Number 5. If you're playing on a big server or just a really laggy world, then this trick is for you. You probably noticed at one point or another that if a server is lagging too much, it becomes hard to eat food in a normal amount of time. Well, this doesn't have to be the case. Yes, most foods will lag when you eat them, but cake won't. Because of how cake works, no matter the lag, you can quickly bite down on some cake to get back your saturation. This is a pretty useful tactic, especially if you're on 2v2t, where you often have to be on the run, and it's generally somewhat laggy. Number 6. If you're a somewhat old player, you might know this one, but it's too cool to leave out. Back in the day, before we had soul sand and water elevators, we would use glass. Not for us, of course, but for items. If you set up a dropper below a column of glass, an item dispensed would make its way to the top in very awesome fashion. You could watch as it seemingly phased through the wall all the way up. You can use this mechanic to make really cool displays for items that don't seem murky or require a lot of work. Number 7. If you ever want to build up somewhere but you also want to get back down easily, so you want to make a staircase, here's a good way to do that. Instead of just basic staircasing, you can save a bunch of resources by just placing a torch on the block you're using. You can keep the torch in your offhand and the blocks in your main hand. Then just place a block on the side of the torch, break the torch, repeat, and boom! A staircase just as effective, but with half the blocks. A really cool little neat trick. Number 8. Here's a really good way to sort through creative inventory you probably never heard of. You ever building something in creative and want to decorate it, and you look for flowers and all that comes up is the cornflower? Well, here's an easy fix for that. Using the pound symbol or hashtag, you can sort through categories of items. Things like hashtag flowers or hashtag fishes or even hashtag piglin loved will sort through these categories of blocks and items, allowing you to find what you need without as much difficulty. I'll leave a link in the description to a list of all the tags if you're interested. It's actually really useful. Number 9. Explosions can be pretty scary, especially if you just finished building your house and realized you forgot to mob-proof it. But one way to make these bombs less harmful is to use slabs. For whatever reason, and I'm sure there is one, explosions like TNT and creepers will be much less powerful if you ignite them on slabs. If I got a creeper on wood planks here on the left and a creeper on a wooden slab here on the right, you can see the difference is pretty notable. So the next time you're making a floor for your base, use slabs instead of full blocks. Not only does it save resources, but it could save you a lot of cleaning up to do. Number 10. Cauldrons in Minecraft are pretty broken. Endermen, mobs which famously don't like water, have no problem chilling in a water cauldron. Likewise, in Bedrock and past versions of Java, mobs that are usually fire resistant, like zombified piglins, burn in lava cauldrons. Additionally, you can burn to death in a lava cauldron while underwater. The game has no problem with a fully functional lava container right in the middle of a lake, allowing you to both burn to death and drown at the same time. Kind of a cursed way to go. Number 11. Fishing rods aren't just used for fishing fish, they can also reel in a ton of other entities. For instance, you can hook and reel shulker bullets and gassed fireballs, leading to some really funny redirection pranks as well as a way to climb up end cities. Additionally, you can also pull prime TNT and anvils, a more dangerous catch that your friends definitely won't see coming. You can even pull certain falling blocks, such as sand or gravel and even the dragon egg. The possibilities are endless. Get it? Endless? Like the okay, bye. Number 12. A common myth in Minecraft is that placing torches disables a spawner. However, this isn't exactly true. There's no magic game mechanic that actually prevents spawners from working if you place torches. It's actually just light levels. The torches just happen to be enough to light up the nearby area to a light level that the spawner doesn't work in. If you obstruct the brightness of the torches, you can see mobs spawn on the outside where it isn't dark. This does mean you can also use jack-o'-lanterns and any other powerful light source to disable a spawner, although yes, torches are more convenient. Additionally, blaze spawners and silverfish spawners can't actually be disabled by measly torches, as their light level requirement is lower, so doing this won't do anything. To disable a blaze spawner, you must arrange glowstone blocks or other strong light sources in this fashion. Number 13. Do you craft your axes left or right? Well, no matter what, you probably agree that we should craft books like this. I mean, it's the only way to craft a book, what am I saying? But it's not. Maybe it's just me, but I only learned a week ago that book crafting is shapeless. So I can craft a book like this. I've been crafting books in the corner literally my whole life, and anything except for this just feels so wrong. Same thing with beetroot soup, I mean, this just looks, not good. But apparently that's shapeless too, who knew? Number 14. With the new axolotls out, everyone wants a bit of this pet in their life. I mean, how could you resist them? They're adorable. And it's just devastating to finally find one of these guys, capture it, and not have a name tag to make them stay. Well, you don't have to. By renaming the actual bucket in an anvil, the axolotl, or any mob in a bucket for that matter, will be renamed as if you used a name tag, a much more convenient and repeatable alternative. Number 15. Raids can be pretty deadly but also pretty annoying when you're just about finished but can't spot that last pillager. Well, here's a quick fix. If you ring the village bell, all remaining raiders within a 48 block radius will have a temporary glowing effect applied to them, allowing you to swiftly and easily hunt them down. Number 16. You probably never noticed this, but skeletons can spawn with different dominant hands. In fact, 11% of all skeletons spawn left-handed, just like the real-life proportion. A cool feature that you never needed to know, but now you do. Number 17. You're most likely familiar with the new loading screen, a little box of varying colors that has a nice and worthless animation, except it actually means something. Each color signifies a different part in the loading process, allowing you to actually troubleshoot what makes your game crash or take a long time to load in a world. The square you're seeing is a 43x43 chunk radius, with each little box being a single chunk. The color is the status of that chunk. Black is empty or not yet loaded. Gray is structures, dark green is biomes, brown is the surface, dark gray is caves and mineshafts, blue is liquids, light green is features, and white is full and done. There's a longer list of colors that you can see on the screen right now if you're interested. Number 18. If you're on Windows, you can add a bunch of useful characters into signs and into chat. Simply press the Alt button on your keyboard as well as the corresponding numpad configuration. For instance, 24 for an arrow, and boom, that will appear in game. There's also a way to do this on macOS, but I don't know it. Number 19. You probably realized this at some point, but certain items have colors. Although, did you ever fully understand it? These colors correspond to an item's rarity. According to Mojang, there are 5 tiers of items: common, uncommon, rare, epic, and ominous. The last, of course, is reserved for an ominous banner, the only item in the game to have an orange color. Uncommon items are usually treasures like Hearts of the Sea and conduits. Rare items include boss drops such as beacons and end crystals. Epic items, apart from the dragon egg, are primarily creative exclusive things like structure blocks and command blocks. And of course, common items are everything else and are in white. Number 20. Flower pots are a nice way to display your shrubs, anything from a prized dead bush to a little pet cactus. But a cool quality of the pot that you might not realize is that they rotate. Viewing it from this angle, it's clear the Lily of the Valley has 2 petals. However, as we rotate around the pot, you can see the flower rotates as well, so whatever angle you look at it from, we'll always see the same thing. Not sure why they added this, but I guess it is aesthetically pleasing. Number 21. The official Minecraft 1.17 trailer was filled with many, many goats. But one that you might not have noticed was this one 24 seconds in. No, not that one. This one. This small, brighter bundle of stars is the constellation Capricornus, which represents the sea goat and is the Latin name for goat horn. It's definitely a nice little Easter egg, but in my heart, you're the real goat. Number 22. Deep Slate used to be called Grimstone, which is a pretty fitting name, and you may wonder why it got changed. Well, according to Brandon Pierce, the word grim has too many negative connotations, and thus the name was altered. Same thing with Netherrack originally being called Bloodstone, although that change is much older. Number 23. Speaking of negative connotations, polar bears were once removed for being too sad. During the development of iceberg biomes, polar bears were temporarily removed from spawning there since Agnes, one of the developers, felt bad watching polar bears just sit on random chunks of ice, unable to go anywhere. That being said, they were eventually allowed back because, sad as it may be, that's how it is in real life too. Number 24. Wolves, or land axolotls, are man's best friend. They're loyal, strong, and adorable. We all know that if there aren't blocks in the way, our wolves will teleport right next to us. However, they can pull up some pretty cool tricks by teleporting into transparent blocks. If there are no other options, a wolf will teleport into a transparent block to be with its owners. A very wholesome and cool feature. Number 25. We talked about the value of mob heads and how cool their detection mechanic is, but did you know they have another weird quirk? The breaking particle of mob skulls, yes, every single one, is none other than that of soul sand. Did someone say lore? Number 26. Speaking of lore, another thing that you might not have known is how often the color cyan shows up in pretty much everything related to Minecraft lore. Eyes of Ender? Cyan. Soul energy and everything undead? Cyan. Ocean monuments, guardians, and the warden? Cyan. The warped forest, literally the only non-red thing in the nether? Cyan. Even cyan glazed terracotta is the only terracotta block to feature a mob. Coincidence? I think not. Number 27. In Minecraft, there are many different types of custom world presets such as ocean worlds, amplified worlds, and debug worlds. But one I want to talk about is the void world. Generating this preset seems to only spawn in a stone platform. Big whoop. However, teleport to these coordinates, the creation date of Minecraft, and you are greeted with a giant Steve head. Nah, I'm just kidding, that's a joke. In actuality, something you may not have known and probably wish you didn't know is this platform isn't centered. Yeah, why not make the center 0-0? I have no idea. Instead, it's 8-8. 8-8. Number 28. Breeding mobs is a pretty common practice in Minecraft, but what if you breed two mobs from different species? Well, you can't, right? Wrong. By feeding a horse and a donkey both a golden carrot, you can actually crossbreed them to make a mule. This mob has characteristics from both a horse and a donkey and can't spawn naturally. It can carry a chest, and its speed depends on how fast the horse is. Pretty cool and useful mob. Number 29. Llamas are not one of the best looking mobs. I mean, they're kinda cute, kind of. But one way to spice up their appearance is with carpets. Not a lot of players realize this, and it's likely you haven't looked into it much either, but llamas have really cool carpet designs. For instance, using a dark gray carpet makes it look like a bandit, and the light gray gives it a cute little bib. So the next time you have a llama pet, show them off with this cute addition. Number 30. If you look carefully at your hotbar, each individual square is actually using a transparent sand texture. That's right, sand. Who knew, huh? But hey, that's that. Those are 30 more secret Minecraft things you probably didn't know. Huge shout out to Skip the Tutorial for the inspiration for this video format. Go subscribe to his channel if you haven't already. I hope you enjoyed, and leave a comment letting me know how many things you knew. But with that said, thank you so much for watching. Please consider subscribing, it helps out a ton. And as always, peace out. Have a good one. I'll see you next time. Thank you so much.